Hi everyone, my name is Nicolas Lanchier. I'm a college professor in mathematics, teaching probability theory for grad students. And to take a break with probability theory at the grad level, I just wanted to do this very short video about a fun probability problem called the Monty Hall Dilemma. The game consists of three doors. Behind one of the doors, there is a price, while behind the other two doors, there is a goat. If you choose a door at random, the probability of finding the price is clearly one third. Now, after you choose a door, Monty opens one of the other two doors to reveal a goat, and you have the choice between sticking to your initial choice or switching door. Because there are two doors left, it seems that the probability of finding the price becomes one half, regardless of your strategy. However, some people argue that switching door doubles your chance of finding the price. So what should we do? Stick to our first choice or switch? The problem is equivalent to the following. Assume for a minute that you are colorblind and your goal is to find the black bishop just by guessing. If your strategy is to stick to your initial choice, the probability that you end up with the black bishop is the probability that you chose the black bishop in the first place, which is one third. But if your strategy is to switch, whenever you choose one of the two white bishops in the first place, which happens with probability two-thirds, Monty will throw away the other white bishop. So you end up with the black bishop. Conclusion, you indeed double your chance of winning by switching. Now let's see why this result might be difficult to understand even if the solution is quite simple. First, like we just said, because we are left with two doors at the second round, it seems that the probability of finding the price should be one half, no matter what. But there is also a common misinterpretation among college students, and I'm going to become a little bit more technical for a minute to explain why. Many of my students struggle also with this problem, and I'm going to explain you why. Here is basically, on this part of the board, how they set up the problem to try to find those probabilities. They first call W, the event that we win, meaning that we find the price, and then they define those two events. So S1 is the event that you stick to your first choice, while S2 is the event that you switch to the other door. And then they try to compute those two things here called conditional probabilities. So that's the conditional probability of winning, given that you use strategy one. So strategy one is stick to your first choice, and they look also at the probability of winning given that you switch. So now the problem in this setting is that the definition of event is very specific in probability theory. So basically an event is something, so if you know probability theory, that's going to be a subset of something that we call a sample space, a set of all possible outcomes of some random experiment. And basically those events may happen or not, and they are attributed some probabilities. So in this setting, you see that in fact they try to think of S1 and S2 as events, while in reality, in the problem, S1 and S2 do not have any probabilities, okay? So this means that thinking of S1 and S2 as events is not correct. In fact, the correct way to do it is to compute what we call the unconditional probability of W if you follow strategy 1 or 2, which is not the same, theoretically, it's not the same as the conditional probability of W given S1 or S2. So basically the main mistake among students who know about probability theory is to think of this problem as a problem in terms of conditional probability, while in reality it's not, it's much simpler than that. We don't need to have any conditional probabilities in the problem. So that's the most common mistake I see from students about this problem. So now a second thing I would like to point out is I noticed that there are other YouTube videos about this problem, about the Monty Hall problem, and many people try to prove try to compute those probabilities of winning given, not given, but if you use one or the other strategy, by looking at the number of times they win in the first N games when using a specific strategy, let's say strategy 2. So what they do typically, and I saw videos where people use cards that they put face down, they just have three cards that they use as like the three doors, two black ones, one red one. The goal is to find the red one, and they just use those cards to play the game and repeat the poem many times, and then they record the number of times they won using strategy 2, and eventually they end up with noticing that about 2/3 of the time they win if they use this strategy, and they deduce that the probability of winning using strategy 2 is indeed 2/3. So strictly speaking, this is not a mathematical proof, this is not a proof, but there is something kind of rigorous behind that. And in fact, the connection between this observation made by some people on YouTube and the theory of probability is a very important theorem in probability theory called the law of large number, or strong law of large number. And this theorem tells you basically that the empirical mean of a random variable is basically going to converge with probability 1 to the theoretical mean. So in the context of the Monty Hall dilemma, what this means is that this number WN, which is a random variable, this is random, okay, for n fixed, this number of times you win in the first n games, if you divide this quantity by n, which this is going to give you basically the fraction of time you win in the first n games, then it can be proved that this is going to converge almost surely, or with probability 1, when n goes to infinity, to the probability of W. And so in this case, indeed, we can prove indeed that WN over N should converge to 2/3. But again, those other videos you can find on YouTube where they repeat the experiment are not completely rigorous, but indeed there is this strong law of large number that justifies indeed that if you repeat the experiment a lot of times and you observe that about 2/3 of the games results in winning, if you play strategy 2, that's some kind of evidence that indeed P of W should be equal to 2/3. That's it for today. I hope you like this video. There are many more fun poems in probability theory like this one, and I'm thinking in particular of the birthday poem, which states basically that 23 people is enough. Now, if you think this video is boring because you are a grad student in mathematics, or even better, if you have a degree, a college degree in mathematics, and you want to learn more about probability theory, then I invite you to look at my much more challenging videos on topics like discrete time Markov chain, random walks, and Poisson processes.